My name's Rita. I'm the licensee of the Adam and Eve. I've been here now for 11 years. Loved every minute. Had really lots and lots of spooky experiences and know lots of tales about the area. We don't see much, but there's certainly some strange events that happen. Keys go missing and reappear. Glasses fall off the shelves, bottles break. We have people get tapped on the shoulder and when there's nobody about, doors shut, bells ring, all that sort of thing.
So Paul, we're at the Adam and Eve pub in Norwich, apparently one of the most haunted pubs in the city and the oldest as well.
Marvellous, John.
It is.
Bit of good atmosphere, I should imagine.
Yeah. So have you been picking anything up out here?
I did, just walking down here to start with a little doggy.
Yeah.
But it's not very historically backed, is it? But I know I've got a murder for sure.
Yes.
In here a long time ago.
That's right.
Because the thump on my head, I can feel it. Mm. I mean, sometimes I see ghosts, I see spirit people, but this is just a sensation of being hit.
All right, well, I can't wait to see what happens when we go inside.
Well, maybe we should pop in.
Let's go inside then. Well, I'm John West and I'm an historian and paranormal investigator, and I've been absolutely fascinated with ghosts since I was a child. And I just love ghost stories and I love haunted buildings and history. And I just love looking into these stories. And I met up with Paul Salmon, the psychic medium, and now we go around Suffolk and East Anglia visiting haunted sites and seeing what we can find.
I'm Paul Salmon and I had no interest in ghost or paranormal activity at all till I hit 30 years old. I was in the kitchen and the kitchen became aglow with orange light. And a voice said, everything's going to be fine. I found myself going to a spiritualist church, and on the first time, the medium that evening said, you'll be doing this one day, you'll become a medium. I said, give away, I won't be, but lo and behold, I am. I met John West, and he said he fancies going ghost hunting. I said, no, I'm not interested. I'd rather communicate with those who've passed over to the living. But I went along. Our first ghost hunt was marvellous. We picked up a murder, I picked up the murder weapon. I described the murderer, the victim. And it's fascinating. And that's what we do.
So, Paul, what are you picking up now?
Well, John, I'm doing a bit of psychometry. You know, when I hold an object and I can hear words or describe something that happened. Or when I touched this beam, I heard the word cloister. Now, cloister means...
monks.
It's part of a monastery, isn't it?
Yeah, monks.
But we're in a pub.
Well, there is a monastic connection with this place because it was owned by monks.
Was it?
Yes. Yeah, the pub dates back about 800 years.
Well, it's a fair age.
Yes, yeah. It's the oldest pub in Norwich.
Well, that would explain why I've got this monk wandering around.
Yeah.
As a ghost.
But there's also apparently a monk buried under the flagstones
as well. Just here?
Yes, just round here.
And it does go all round here, this monk, so...
Monks have been seen, yes.
Yeah, I was going to say, other people have seen this monk.
Yeah.
And I've got a door that keeps opening.
Mm.
I don't know if anyone's seen this door, but in my mind's eye, it keeps opening and shutting.
Well, I do know there's been poltergeist activity in the pub. Things have been moved, including tankards and stuff like that.
Yeah. So the odd door now and again...
Bound to, isn't it?
Bound to happen.
Yeah, yeah.
Marvellous.
Of course, you're a medium.
Mm-hmm.
And what does that actually mean for people who've never heard of what a medium does?
Well, a medium is a go-between, if you like, between those who've passed on. And I'm like a telephone, if you like.
Right.
I can pass on the message from those who've passed on and to those living on the earth plane.
Mm.
So, like, to prove life after life, that we just don't die, we do continue living. And I like to give a bit of comfort, you know, to those down here.
So you've been here some time now, so what have you actually picked up then, in the way of spirits?
Well, just coming here, I picked up a hanging.
Right.
Which I believe happened outside somewhere?
Yes, actually outside. I was talking to the barman earlier and he said there were hangings outside this very pub.
I did pick up a biggie.
Mm.
I've got a murder.
A murder.
Which isn't surprising, is it? Because this pub's, a few hundred years old. But I felt a pain in my head. You see, sometimes I get... I feel the pain, I feel emotions, or I see things, or hear.
Mm.
But at this moment in time, I got a big bang on my head.
Well, that would fit.
Right, and it's the left side.
Yes, yeah.
Right? And I know this bang was so big, the man died of it. you could not survive what I felt.
Well, there is a murder connected with this building, so you're spot on.
But do you know if it was his head?
It was, apparently, yes. Yeah. He received a blow to the head and he died in this very pub.
Another spirit that haunts this pub is the spirit of Lord Sheffield. He was employed to fight the Kett's Rebellion, which were the peasants that were revolting. He realised he was losing, so he stood just across from the pub, took off his helmet to admit defeat, but a butcher who didn't know what that meant in military terms took his cleaver and struck him about the head, which killed him. And his ghost is said to haunt this pub now.